You're being obscene.
Excuse me.
Who are you?
Jean Vernon. I'm the regional services officer.
Oh, yes. I've heard about you. Well, you'll be wasting your time with these women, if you ask me.
And who, may I ask, are you?
Miss Bennett. I'm the deputy governor here.
Oh, yes. I've heard a lot about you, too. Do you mind if I go and see Mrs. Brooks for a moment?
Right. You've got 1 minute to get out of here, Cook.
Mrs. Brooks.
Miss Vernon, what happened? Did you see her? I've been waiting to hear.
Yes, I had a talk with her yesterday with some difficulty. Your granddaughter's very uptight, Mrs. Brooks.
Yes, I know. And all this sneaking around doesn't help. But did she tell you what was wrong?
Well, I must have convinced her of something because she's waiting for you inside now.
Can I see her right now?
I think you'd better, just in case she disappears again.
Thank you, Miss Vernon. Thank you. Judy.
Hello, Grandma.
I'll be outside.
I didn't think I'd see you again after the last time.
I'm sorry.
Oh, I can't blame you, dear. It's not like visiting a grandmother in a little cottage with roses and a white picket fence, is it?
I wouldn't care where you were. I'd still want to come and see you.
There is something wrong, isn't there, dear? If it's because of me, I know your mother doesn't want you to see me. Perhaps it would be best if you
didn't... that?
You know, when your mother was your age and she was worried about something, I'd know she wanted to talk, but the trouble was to get her to start. Once she had you, well, you couldn't stop her.
She wasn't pregnant though, was she? You're shocked at me, aren't you?
I'm not very easily shocked anymore, darling. No. But I suppose I am surprised.
I'm not ashamed, you know.
Should I ask who the father is?
He's a boy at school in my class. He's very nice.
Has he? Has he offered to marry you?
Well, we've talked about it, but... Well, he's going to uni next year to do engineering, and... Well, he hasn't got any money, and there'd be no way he could look after us and get his degree. Anyway, I don't want to marry him.
Have you told your parents?
Mum wants me to have an abortion.
And your father?
You know, Dad, he goes along with what Mum says. But I want to have it, and I'm going to.
Do you have any idea what it's like to bring up a child on your own, Judy?
You want me to get rid of it too, don't you?
I didn't say that.
Look, I'm not a child. I'm 16. I've thought about this, and I think I'll make a good mother.
I think you will too, darling.
Oh, Grandma, I knew you would. That's why I wanted to tell you. I just thought you'd be ashamed of me.
Oh, my dear girl, how could I possibly ever be ashamed of you?
Mum is. She says that if I have the baby, I'll have to move out of the house.
Lorraine wouldn't turn.
Dad's been good. I mean, he still feels the same as Mum, really. He doesn't want me to move out of the house, but he still thinks I'm a child and couldn't bring up a baby.
You can't, Judy, not on your own. How would you live?
I can get a job for a few months. And then when the baby comes along, I'll have something put aside. Well, the government helps single mothers. And Grandma, when you get out, you can come and live with us. And I can get a job to keep us, and you can look after the baby.
Yes, of course, Mr. Bradshaw. You just ring my secretary and make an appointment. No, I don't foresee any problems. As far as I'm concerned, we have a very strong case. You leave the worrying to me, all right? My pleasure. Sorry about that, Dr. Miller. Now, where were we? The appeal for a retrial, yeah?
Karen Travers.
Yes, well, now, I've had a look at the trial transcripts and I've read Mr. Baldwin's report. And I really don't see anything there that would justify a retrial.
Yes, but...
Now, please, let me explain. It could save us both a lot of time and I'm sure you're as busy as I am. Now, firstly, an appeal should be lodged within 1 month of sentencing. Mrs. Travers should have contacted us, and we would have made an application on her behalf to the Supreme Court for a retrial. Now, that wasn't done.
Ah.
And secondly, A retrial can only be granted if new evidence has come to light or if certain evidence was withheld. Do you have that evidence?
When Mrs. Travers was first admitted to prison, I treated her for cigarette burns on her back. Now, she says her husband did that. And from further conversation, I gather the husband was some kind of a sadist. Now, none of this came out of the trial. If it had, well, then her defense could have been that she was driven to killing him.
Sounds a pretty thin defense. In any case, it's hardly enough evidence for a retrial. How do we know Mrs. Travers didn't enjoy being beaten up by her husband? Why didn't she just run away?
Well, just a minute, Mr. Wilson.
Drink?
No, thank you.
You see, Dr. Miller, I'm a reasonably successful lawyer. And if I were to go about taking on all the cases of those people who wanted to appeal against their sentences, then I would be laughed out of profession. I ask myself, for instance, why did Mrs. Travers take so long before bringing this up, when she had every opportunity to do so at the trial? And also, it comes to mind that prisoners might just make up stories like this in order to get a reduced sentence.
I believe that she didn't want to defend herself, that she had such guilt feelings that she wanted to punish herself more than justice may have required.
Punish herself, eh? Well, don't you think that shows signs of masochism, that perhaps she did derive some sort of pleasure out of being abused by her husband?
No.
I'm merely being cautious, Dr. Miller. Because before I even think about making an application to the Supreme Court, I must have valid evidence.
Look, will you take the case or not?
I'll agree to see her, that's all. And if I think what she says is true, then, and only then, will I consider taking her as a client. But before I even do that, I should tell you that I don't handle legal aid cases and my services don't come cheaply.
I'll cover all the costs. And I'd be grateful if Mrs. Travers didn't know about that.
Agreed. All right. I'll let you know when I can see Mrs. Travers.
Mr. Francis Lake clung to his upturned boat for 4 hours before rescuers reached him.
Turn that thing down, I'm trying to study. Shut up,
Lizzie. Let's listen to the news, you might learn something.
Women escapees who broke out of Wentworth Prison last week have not yet been apprehended.
Oh, hooray!
Women Frieda Doyle and Doreen Anderson are believed to be dangerous.
Turn that radio off.
Police are hopeful of an early arrest.
You can have this back. And I think you've earned it.
Why, a fair go. We were only listening to the news.
Oh, yeah, Miss.
Be quiet. Thought you'd like to know. Another woman's just come in. I'm putting her in with you and Mason.
So?
Well, I don't think even you'll be able to handle this one. We'll soon see who's tough around here.
Been said before.
Yeah, just the same. I wonder what she will be like.
Caviar comes from a virgin, sturgeon, virgin, surgeon's a very fine dish.
Please stop that noise.
Sturgeon needs no virgin, that's why caviar's a very fine dish.
Get out of that chair.
Boyfriend, no. He was a virgin through.
Will you listen to me?
I gave caviar to me boyfriend.
Why isn't that woman dressed? She should have been taken to her cell by now. I can't get her out, Vera. Every time I go near her, she threatens me. Well, we'll see about that. Ferguson! Ferguson! If you're not out of that shower in 2 seconds, I'll call officers and have you hauled out.
Keep your shirt on. You screws could do with a bit of a wash now and then.
Are you sure your daughter will throw her out?
I don't know. I can't believe Lorraine would be as hard as that. But from the way Judy's talking, she seems determined to move out on her own anyway.
Well, I've seen enough of unmarried mothers to know that that's not easy. And I'll be honest with you. If she isn't capable of looking after the child, they'll take it away from her.
I know. Oh, I feel so useless. I had my chance to start again. If only I'd known this was going to happen. You know, I've always believed in no regrets. Until now.
Why did you want to come back here, Mrs. Brooks?
Loneliness. I thought my family had rejected me. Oh, I wasn't going to keep that jewelry. Heavens, nothing was further from my mind. I only took it so that I could be arrested. I wanted to come back here. Home. Outside, this seemed the only place I belonged. But now, for the first time in over 12 years, when anyone really needs me, like I... Thank you.
it's all right for you. You're getting out in a few days.
Oh, you'll be all right, B. And you got the other women on your side?
Oh, they're not much good when it comes to the crunch.
Do you really reckon she's as bad as Bennett makes out?
That bitch doesn't make threats unless she really means them.
Well, what are you going to do?
Show her who's boss, right from the start.
Your new cellmate is here.